I'm going to share with you some thoughts, some ideas, and some strategies that have helped me and literally hundreds, if not thousands of other people over the years come up with money, come up with resources literally out of thin air for their business. So stop whatever you're doing, pay close attention for the next little while I'm with you, so you can pay close attention and to really embrace these ideas. Have an open mind to receive some information that can inspire you on creating resources for your business. I've been talking to a lot of people lately in our business about what we do and inside of Techademics and about our different products and programs such as Tech Week and Ecom Incubator, things that are higher prices, right? And so many times people want to do something and they don't yet have the resources, or they don't think they have the resources to move forward to invest in themselves, their business, training, education, mentorship. Maybe you're looking for more resources to fund your advertising, so let's say build, grow, and scale an online e-commerce store. Or maybe you're looking to join a mastermind or get some education, or maybe you're just looking for resources to invest, or whatever the case may be. At the end of the day, the number one challenge, you know, I know you can probably relate, I know I can relate, and how most entrepreneurs face is money. Right? The number one objection to sales generally is money, right? I would love to do this. I'd love to buy your product or service, but I don't have the money. So I'm going to share with you some ideas to be able to overcome this objection for yourself and for your prospects, your customers, your team members, when it comes to the idea of, hey, I'd love to do this, but I don't have the money. And it first starts with this idea, okay, of shifting your mindset of scarcity to abundance, realizing that money is all around you. Now, when I say that, some of you may be thinking, well, yeah, sure, Peter, you know, you might say that, or you guys are successful, or whatever the case may be. You know, I'm struggling to pay my rent, right? I get it. I've been there before. It wasn't that long ago, years back, that I was struggling to be able to pay my rent. I was literally facing potential eviction. I had tens and tens of thousands of credit card debt, hundreds of thousands of dollars of mortgage debt. And I was stuck and didn't know what to do. But even in that moment, I learned from successful mentors that said, you know what? Money is just an idea. Money is all around me. You know, out there in the universe, in today's real world, money is exchanging constantly, right? There are resources to be able to tap into, not only your own resources, but the resources of other people, when you begin to adopt the primary belief that, again, money is all around me and money comes from people. Okay, so give you a real world classic example. You know, I have a big back in real estate. Many, many years ago, I tapped into this idea of self-directed retirement funds, 401ks, IRAs, different plans out there where there are trillions of dollars in these funds. Now, I at the time didn't have a retirement plan. I didn't have any money at that time really, but I learned about this idea that, wow, there's trillions of dollars in retirement plans. What if I could actually go to someone that had a 401k and IRA and assist them in self-directing that plan and be able to partner with me on real estate deals where we could both make money together and they could be, you know, have a vested interest in building a business together, right? That was an idea, okay? The idea being that there are resources out there, and whether I personally have them or not, there are other people that have them. So what can I do to be able to align myself with people, to be able to share and roll them in what I'm doing, share the vision, share the ideas, okay? And to be able to create a win-win to where it made sense for them as my money partner or as my investor, okay? So that was the first belief, and I want to give to you, is again that money is everywhere. Money is all around you. And if you want to get more money, again, it's going to come from people, whether that's someone you know, whether that's someone you don't know, whether that is a bank or an institution or a funding source or a credit line, or whether it's a retirement plan of yourself that you have or from someone else, whether you're selling something to someone to raise some money, no matter what it is, money comes from other people. Now, a very, very famous book written over 100 years ago called Science of Getting Rich. It was written by Wallace D. Wattles in 1910, I believe. And way back then, Wallace D. Wattles understood this idea, right, that money is an exchange of value, that money is energy, just like everything else, just like I shared in the law of vibration. Everything is energy and has a vibration, right? So money is energy. Now, he talked about Wallace D. Wattles in Science of Getting Rich that the key to success, the key to wealth and abundance, was to give more in use value. Okay, write this down if you're taking notes. Give more in use value than you receive in cash value, right? So in practical terms, I have a product, right? And that product is $20. Maybe you sell a little widget on your e-commerce store or something like that. You have a little $20 product. And people are going to receive more value The reason why they're going to buy it is because they perceive that they're going to receive more value than, let's say, that $20. Now, the same thing can be said about, let's say, a $10,000 product. Take our Tech Week, our $10,000 program, good for two people, an entire year of education, live experience classes that we teach by practitioners. That's a $10,000 program. So take that as an example. Well, someone's going to buy that because they believe they're going to receive way more than $10,000 in use value. That the $10,000 that they're going to spend and they're going to invest to be able to get that education, get that program, could be worth far more than $10,000, right? Otherwise, they wouldn't buy it. So what are you marketing? What are you promoting? What are you selling? And the key is, how do you give more in use value than you're going to receive in cash value? Now, this is the same idea and principle when it comes to raising money. If you want to raise, let's say you need to raise 10, 25, 30 grand for your business. You know, let's say our e-com incubator, a lot of people have been raising money for that. It's a $25,000 program. Well, if you're raising money for a high ticket program like that, how can you come up with the money? Let's say you're going to partner with someone. Maybe you're going to go out there and connect with someone that you know, that knows, likes, and trusts you, that has the money, that has the resources, or that has the credit. Maybe you don't have the money or the credit, but you know someone that does. How do you go out there and actually create an opportunity for them? Create what's called a win-win, to where maybe they're the money partner and you're the marketing partner. Maybe you're gonna be the one that does what it takes and you're gonna do all the research and product research and all the Facebook ads and do all of the work to make it successful, right? And that you need the right training and education and live hands-on experience, let's say like our e-com incubator program. Well, that example, okay, if you don't have the resources yourself, but it's something you're committed to and something you absolutely, without a shadow of doubt, wanna do, then maybe you go out there and get a money partner. Again, that's just one of dozens and dozens of ideas. What I want you to do is write down, what is it that you really, really want? Okay? What is it that you want? What is something that you need to raise money for? Right? For your business, or maybe advertising costs, or maybe it's, you know, some type of coaching or mastermind again, or, you know, maybe you just need to be able to raise some money to be able to take your family on vacation. Whatever the case may be, write that down. Step number one, write it down. Get clear on what you want to create. Get clear on what you want to manifest. Step number two, I want you to sit in a quiet space at some point and visualize yourself already having that result, what you want. Step number one. So visualize what you want. Feel the feelings of already having it right now. Okay? Take a moment and begin to visualize and feel the feelings of you having that which you declared, that which you're committed to creating. Right? So maybe it's coming up with 25 grand, whatever the case may be. Okay. Feel, how does it feel when you've already done that? You've raised the money, you've come up with the resources. How does that feel? Right? So that's step number two. Step number three is, I want you to sit down and write a list. And this is where you begin to tap into the power of your unconscious or subconscious mind. You begin to tap into the power of your subconscious mind. I want you to write down a list of 50 ideas. And when I say 50, that might sound like a stretch. It might sound like a lot. Well, 50, wow. I want you to force yourself to tap into your power of your subconscious mind. What this exercise is going to do, it's going to allow you to think creatively. And what's going to happen is you're going to get in kind of a meditative state, if you will. You're going to get inspired ideas. You're going to think of ideas you hadn't thought of before when it comes to creating resources, when it comes to creating money, when it comes to raising money for your business. You're going to think of people that you hadn't thought of before. Oh, I know that person. Oh, I could talk to this person about my business. You're gonna come up with ideas, people, different opportunities to be able to take action on. Now, here's what I'm gonna suggest. If there's an idea, write down to 50, right? If you're stuck at 10, 20, keep going, right? And here's the thing, you might get idea number three might be the winner for you, and that's cool, but it might take 50. But here's what's gonna happen. You're gonna get, as you go through this process, you're gonna have things that inspire you. You're gonna have things that maybe frighten you. There might be an idea, maybe a person to contact, right? Maybe someone to reach out to, maybe an asset to leverage that maybe it gives you fear regarding to contact that person or to pull from resources. Maybe that, you know, you had those, but you didn't really wanna tap into them for your business because you were scared. I'm gonna challenge you that more than likely, and this may not be the case for everyone, but more than likely, that which fears you, that you're scared of, is probably something you should take action on. If there's someone that you're afraid to talk to, you know, back in the network marketing days, you'd call it your chicken list, right? You're too chicken to call them because maybe you're fearful of what they would say or how they would judge you, or they're too successful, right? They wouldn't be interested in your business or what you're doing. I'm going to challenge you to take action on that. If there's something or a list of things that you're afraid of doing, do them. Successful people, I want you to get this. Successful people have fears. Successful people have worries. They have doubts. The difference is they act in spite of those fears. They take action in spite of those fears. So they take action and they make those calls, right? They do those actions. They leverage those resources to tap into to start, grow, and build their business, right? The fact of the matter is every single day, billions and billions of dollars every year, hundreds of billions of dollars are being raised for new businesses here in the United States alone and all over the world. And most of that money comes from people they know, from credit lines, banks, institutions, things like that, right? Just those two ideas alone are responsible than more than half of all of the hundreds of billions of dollars that get funded to start new businesses. So that's where the money is. But if you're afraid to tap into that, or you're afraid to make those contacts, you're never going to more than likely create the resources. You're never going to raise the resources for your business. And here's the thing, it's not only for yourself. Maybe you have the money. Maybe you have a 800 plus credit score. You got tons of money in the bank. You got assets. You're good. But guess what? Maybe you're selling or promoting something and your customers, your prospects, your team members, maybe they don't have the resources. So the more you learn how to overcome the money objection, not only for yourself, but for other people, the more money, the more sales you're going to make in your business. Well, this is one of the ideas that I learned a long time ago, what I kind of got affectionately known as the Get Money Guy, because I learned how to be able to become resourceful at finding the resources. I became resourceful of coming up with money. When I needed to come up with 50 grand to buy a real estate deal and I didn't have any money or any credit, and I became resourceful and I started saying, who do I know that has money? Who do I know that has a retirement plan? Who do I know that may be interested in building a business online? You know, who do I know that could tap into, I could be able to partner with? Or guess what? You know, what resources do I have that I'm not really using? Or what assets do I have that I'm not leveraging properly? Because successful people understand leverage. They understand how to be able to get leverage from people, from different assets, different business ideas, right? They understand partnerships that, you know, they say teamwork makes the dream work, that it becomes, there is no self-made millionaire. We all have teams, we all have partners, we all have leverage, those that are creating success. So when it comes to overcoming money, the money objection, think about this. Think about, okay, what must you do to inspire someone else to overcome that objection? What can you say? What vision can you create for someone else? Let's say I have a coaching client and I have a $10,000 coaching program, right? If I'm going to talk to that potential client, they want to do it. Now, the next step would be, you know, hey, how would it feel to have that success? Maybe they have an online business they're growing. What would it feel like to be able to earn a six-figure income online and be able to travel with your family all over the world? What would it feel like to be debt-free? How would that feel? What would that do for you that you don't have right now? What would that get you that you don't have right now? Right? And they begin to open up and begin to share at a deeper level. Well, you know, that would give me freedom. That would give me security. I would feel successful, right? Awesome. So now let's take that, those feelings of the present moment. You're feeling grateful. Okay, how can you then transition yourself or transition your customer or prospect into saying, okay, let's talk about the money. How are you going to fund this? What ideas have you thought of already? Okay, besides the money, what else is holding you back? They may say, you know what, nothing. I just need to find the money. Okay, great. Let's look into this. What are your resources? There's three types of resources: financial resources, relationship resources, and idea resources. And another way of saying that, there's three types of capital: financial capital, relationship capital, and intellectual capital, right? Because you might not have the money, but you might know someone. That's relationship capital. Who does? Or you might not have the money, but you have an idea of how to go out there and get it, and how to raise it, how to find it, how to sell something to come up with the money, right? So again, there's three types of capital: financial, relationship, right, and intellectual. So you've got to begin to tap into your power subconscious mind by doing that exercise I shared with you, be able to be unafraid to go after the things that maybe you're afraid of, right? Be willing to overcome your fear and take action on the inspired ideas that you get, that you tap into the power of your subconscious mind by going through that written exercise and coming up with those ideas. And here's what's powerful. As you begin to overcome the money objection for yourself, right? Maybe it's a challenge for you to get all in your business. Maybe it's a challenge for you to, again, come up with the money so you can get the education, the resources, the tools, the mentorship, the support that you need to build, grow, and scale a successful business online, for example, right? Well, if you overcome that objection for yourself, you're now going to be able to share that with your potential customers, your potential team members, right? You're going to be able to assist them in overcoming that money objection for themselves. And when you do this, you're going to help your people overcome the number one objection, which again is money. And when you do that, your people are going to buy. And when they buy, you're going to make money, right? The more skillful you get at this, the more ideas you can come up with of how to overcome the money objection for yourself, the more you're going to be able to help people overcome that, the more money you're going to make. It's a win-win-win, right? So again, I want you to be thinking about, again, money is just an idea. It's all around you. If you don't have the money for your business, someone else does. How can you leverage the efforts of someone else? How can you leverage their money and make a win for them? Give them more value, right? One of our e-com incubator student partners, you know, raised 25 grand for his e-com incubator business, his e-commerce business, by saying, hey, you know what? I'll give so much value to you. You've got money. You don't have time. You want to learn e-commerce. You want to have an e-commerce store, but you don't have a lot of time. You know what? I'll invest the time. I'll get the knowledge. I'll help build the first store for you. I'll get it up and running. I'll get it profitable, and I'll give you that store. You can keep the store. I just want the story. I want the story and the experience of a successful e-commerce business. That's going to help me make money in my affiliate marketing business as well. And you know what? Once I do it with one store, I can do it again and again and again and again, right? So here's the thing. He had an idea, no resources, and he came up with 25 grand like that. In a matter of a few phone calls and conversations, he was able to leverage the resources of someone else, create a win-win with them, create a win with that money partner, and to be able to invest in himself and his business, right? So that's just one idea. What's one story out of hundreds I could share with you of tapping in to this idea that money's all around you, that money's just an idea. And if you don't have the money, you're just an idea away. Right? The key is to take action on that idea. Don't let the ideas fester. Take massive action, immediate massive action on the idea, right? Take action on the idea. Don't be afraid. Fear comes up, recognize it, say thank you for sharing, and continue to move forward, right? Don't let your fear hold you back. Oh, you know what? I tried that in the past, it didn't work. Or you know what? I spent all this money in the past and I'm afraid it won't work out. You know, I had failures in the past. Leave the failures of your past in the past. Leave your present, your future open, wide open to success, wide open to possibilities, right? Leave your past in the past so you can create a blank canvas for your future, that you can design it, that you can paint it out to whatever you want it to be, right? So get clear on what you want, okay? Feel the feelings of already achieving that which you want in the present moment. Feel the feelings of gratitude. Write out a list of 50 ideas, tap into the power of your subconscious mind, write out that list. Step number 4, take massive action, take inspired action on the ideas that you come up with. Do not stop, do not quit. And step number 5, receive. Accomplish the objective, overcome the money objection for yourself, and not only that, I'll give you a little bonus step, pay it forward to someone else. Share this type of message with your customers, your team members. Share the message of overcoming the money objection for their challenge. Because again, service is sales and sales is service. Sales is really nothing more than service. Helping people get what they want, right? The professional salesperson understands this. The professional salesperson understands it's about helping people get more of what they want, right? You help enough people get what they want, as Zig Ziglar said, you'll have everything you want, okay? So take massive action.